In my opinion, life is a kind of game where we achieve our goals. Today, my dear friends, I want to share with you about how to play this game, or to be precise, what is a game theory. Game theory is a method of finding optimal strategies in games using math.
In the concept of game theory, a game is a process in which two or more participants are fighting to realize their interests. Each of the participants uses a certain strategy, which depending on the decision of other players, can lead to a win or loss.
Now, let's talk about how it started. First concepts of game theory were described in the classic book of great mathematicians like John von Neumann and Oscar Morgenstern in 1944. At that time, all the concepts of game theory analyzed zero-sum games, where winners win at the expense of losers. As an example, this is poker, where one picks all the bets of others. Then, in 1949, mathematician John Nash develops methods of analysis where all participants either win or lose, despite the fact they competed. Test situations were called non-cooperative equilibrium or Nash equilibrium, which I will explain later.
As a result of this research, game theory has become popular in economics, business science, psychology, computer science, and biology.
Despite this fact, the game theory is everywhere around us. And to prove it, let's get acquainted with one main paradox of game theory, which says if people don't cooperate with each other and think only themselves, then often situations where everyone loses are developed.
For example, let's imagine two cousins, Sam and Bob, who by unimaginable coincidence wanted to sell unique clothing socks that Spencer wore in iCarly. Since they are brothers, Bob and Sam made an agreement to sell socks by equally high prices. Their initial profit was $300 each. One day, Bob decides to lower his prices, what makes him earning $400. Sam notices that his profit has fallen to $200 and also reduces his prices to return customers. After this, Bob and Sam start earning $50 less than if they agreed to cooperate. This state is called Nash equilibrium because it's beneficial to save this balance, since any change except agreement will worsen their financial situations.
For that reason, large companies compete in no price range and try to distinguish their products from others by making innovations and improvements. But in most cases, the best outcome is only possible when cooperating. Anyway, cooperate or not is your choice.